They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a skill, but the piano professor says it should take a lot less. It's all about how you practice, not how long. That's what we focus on. Now, let's look at today's video.
The question, is it true that the performance of a pianist depends also on the quality of his or her piano? I would say so, if it weren't for my brother who can make the cheapest Casio sound good. Seen in terms of attack, decay, sustain and release, answer, the envelope at the heart of synthesizer study, the better the piano you learn on, the better you appreciate what a quality instrument has to offer. Control of the attack of a note gives us choices as far as how hard the hammers contact the strings. The quality piano has a sophisticated mechanical system controlling the hammers. Decay and sustain are related in an acoustic instrument. What happens to the sound of a note immediately after you strike it is called decay. The attack takes place in just a fraction of a moment. Depending on the room you're in, whether you have the piano lid closed or opened, and the quality of the wooden frame, a note will die, resonate, or something in between. The next portion of the death of a note is sustain. If you release the key right away, you'll have no sustain, hold the key down and the note will die off in a way characteristic of that piano. That's sustain. Finally, release is letting go of the key. One's choices range from jumping off instantaneously to a drawn-out float-off, in which the finger lingers, sorry, at a point somewhere between two-thirds and fully off. The contact to damper makes will choke the note slowly and give the impression of fading away, as opposed to a dead stop. The damper pedal does the same thing to all 88 keys at once. Understanding these properties, we develop a sense of our choices for how each note should sound. An instrument of poor quality hinders our ability to make the music sound the way we have in mind. It can be doubly tricky, if not every note is behaving the same way. In my experience, the opportunity to play a Steinway or Busendorfer piano in top working condition makes me feel like a king. I tend to notice how good I sound. Some players, my brother included, have such a well-developed sense of what the music should sound like and what makes it happen, they quickly compensate for a bad piano. That said, when you play a good Steinway, it might sound so good you don't even have to know what you're doing. Learning the piano without spending decades on it is about working smart, not hard. You can access the Piano Professor Pack in the link below. It focuses on abusing diminishing returns to get the best results possible.